of NASCAR. Visit NASCAR Thunder locations now open in all of those cities you see. And you can also check the website, www.country.com, and get all the information about NASCAR Thunder, the official store of NASCAR. Warm day here at Heartland Park in Topeka. Temperature at 100 degrees. Feels like 105. Going to be tough on the cooling system. Not a whole lot of grill space, although more than, I guess, on a race car, Larry, but it's still going to be a handful in the heat of this Midwest.
In this much heat, you've got to open a lot of the front end. See, there's no tape at all on the front end of that truck. Now, for qualifying, these guys will tape up just as much as they can because it really reduces the drag for these trucks to go down these long straightaways and also put some downforce in the front of the truck. When you open them up, you have to do it for the heat. It makes the drag go up and actually takes some downforce away, which you have to work on the truck to turn a little better.
As a matter of fact, our AutoZone Tech Fact today is with Barry Dodson, who spent some time explaining how to try and keep the truck cool in this high humidity.
At a lot of tracks in Craftsman Truck Series, we don't get a lot of practice. We try to utilize what practice we get to try to get ready to qualify and be up front. To do that, you have to have the truck taped up pretty heavily, so it wants to run hot. Well, here's how you fix that. It's with this baby right here. It's built by CNR out of Indianapolis. It's just another radiator, just like we have in the truck, except this baby's filled up with ice water. Let me show you how it works. Mike comes in, we plug it in right here to the quick coupler. It sends ice cold water all through the system, pushes the hot water back out here. It goes back through the radiator and recirculates it. We can be back on the track in just a couple minutes.
Just some more of the technology involved in the world of NASCAR racing. There you see the cleanup continuing to Bill Sedgwick's truck. They have a good bit of fluid that has been leaking from the rear of the vehicle. They have put down a lot of speedy dry and continue. Here comes the speedy dry truck again. They're even having to do it by hand because of the volume of the fluid. So we stay under caution with Boris Sed, the leader. www.nascar.com. All the latest NASCAR news, scoring of the races as they unfold, personality bios, statistics, even weather reports and radar from the locations where NASCAR racing is being run. It's all right there at www.nascar.com. Your 24-hour NASCAR Garage Pass. Field now set to go green. Cleanup is wrapping up. That machine, that cleanup truck backing up to the head end of the drag strip. And the green is in the air. Boris Sed with Ron Hornaday trying to take the top spot away.
Eli, we run three caution laps. And normally on a road course, three caution laps is equivalent to about 1.5 green laps. So obviously by Boris Sed and his team electing not to pit, they're making a statement, guys, we think we can go the distance. On a road course, you normally get worse fuel mileage than you do on an oval. It's no different in your passenger car. When you're out on the highway and you're consistent with your speed, your fuel mileage is a lot better than when you're around town on and off the gas, which these trucks are a lot here at this road course.
Glenn, has Boris said anything about strategy?
Boris said, crew chief said, which is Jay Smith, told me, quote, unquote, we ain't pitting, man. We're not coming in. We can make it the rest of the way thanks to that caution. I said, what do you do if you run out of gas? He said, we get somebody to push him around. So they are definitely not going to pit. Update on some of the things going on down here. We saw Mike Wallace in. They got a brake problem, front brake problem. They keep working on that. Also, Jack Sprague has reported now he has a right front rubbing, so he's got a little problem too. But Morris said he's staying out.
He might have even exclaimed that. You never know. Underneath the bridge, back out onto the drag strip here off this final turn. It'll be lap number 21 as they come back to start finish of 81 that are being run here today. Riding with Mike Bliss, he's in fifth now, and you see how he has worked forward, then dropped back with his pit stop, and then moved back towards the front. MCI bringing you NASCAR timing and scoring across the top of the screen. So you'll know how your favorites are doing. Lance Norrick, Ron Fellows, Bill Sedgwick in the garage area right now. Everybody else still out there and running. Skinner, three truck, that's Sauter. Dave Resendi's moving to the front. He's in seventh now Remember, he won the road course race at Sears Point. 55, Dorsey Schrader. 29, Keselowski. Kenny Irwin. 43 is Jimmy Hensley. Chuck Bown, who's made a couple of pit stops. One is Bobby Hamilton, visiting from the NASCAR Winston Cup Series. He was the Busch pole sitter here yesterday in the Slim Jim All-Pro Series race.
Goodyear's brought a really good tire here, Eli. This is the same tire that the Winston Cup cars run at Sonoma, and it really has a lot of staying power, even though this track gets really hot and slick. The times don't really fall off that much. They was off right away from the beginning of the race, actually about 2 to 3 seconds off what they qualified, but it seems like they kind of stay there even many laps into the race.
Good battle there. You saw Rick Crawford just to the right there in that blue truck. Jay Sauter in the 3. The 35, that green and yellow truck, that's Dave Resendiz. You're looking there at 5th, 6th, and 7th. Tony Raines in the 19 truck. He is in the 8th spot. And one truck spins here at the entrance. That's Chuck Bown. Chuck Bown, who came off turn 12, spun as he went towards that burnout area on the drag strip. And now manages to continue away in the X-side truck number 99. Chuck running in 27th position. Let's see if we can figure out exactly what happened.
Coming off the last corner there, got up on those rumble strips and just maybe was too far on them and was actually part on the rumble strips, part on the slick part of the racetrack, and it just come around on him. Got away. A little bit of damage to the left rear there, but I don't think anything that really will affect the truck. Spins it around real quickly and gets going.
Good bit of damage, though, you see there at the left rear of the X-side Ford. First road race for Chuck in a couple of years. He ran a number of West Coast road races and even ran at the old Breyer Motorsports Park, which is now where the Loudoun, New Hampshire International Speedway is, when Chuck was up in that part of the country. And it's been a while for him on the road circuits. Meanwhile, the battle for the lead up front has really tightened up again. It's coming right at you through the heat waves of this Sunday afternoon in Topeka. Hornaday looking, but can't get the jump on Boris Said.
Boris's truck really runs good down at the end of that long drag strip, the end of the front straightaway.
Boris doesn't show a ton of emotion, but all week long, I happened to talk to him on Tuesday, from out in California, and he said, man, these days aren't going by quickly enough till I can get back to the road course.
Well, you know, even way back when it was announced he was going to drive this truck at the beginning of the year, I think probably the first thing that popped in everybody's mind is, heck, these trucks go to 3 road courses, and we're sure Boris is going to be tough. And again, I think he has surprised people at his performance on the ovals.
He really has. He's learned. Well, he's a good, talented race driver, no doubt about it. And he's really picked up the pace on the ovals nicely. Glenn, what are you hearing about Chuck Bound's problems? How significant are they?
I think it's mostly sheet metal, Eli. They've been talking about bringing him in, but Chuck says the truck's okay. I just happened to be looking right at that. He got in that corner starting off down the drag strip there, and he got a little bit squirrely. Jack Sprague was right behind him, had nowhere to go, and he got into Chuck. That's what spun him around. If you look at the, if you can see next time we show it, the damage on the left rear of Chuck's truck, I think that came from the contact with Sprague, but I don't believe it was Jack's fault. Just two guys at the same place. Chuck had a little problem there.
Chuck in 27th position right now. Meanwhile, up front, here goes Hornaday. Gets a jump this time midway down the drag strip, and he'll grab the lead from Boris Said.
Just pulled out, went by him on the inside, down that long drag strip, pulled back in line before they even got to turn one.
So for the second time today, Ron Hornaday will take the lead. Let's see if Boris can hang with him. You've got Mike Skinner in the 93 truck right behind. These vehicles take abuse on a road course.
It's hard on a lot of things, hard on a lot of the suspension, ball joints, Panhard bars. We saw some cars yesterday in that race break some Panhard bars. It's just because the truck is never loaded one direction. It's back and forth across the rumble strips. Pretty much after a road race, even if you win the race, you pretty much got to go back and throw most of the suspension parts away.
And this is kind of like a left-handed road course anyway, more so than some of the others around the country, Glenn. It really is a handful for the guys that you're dealing with down there on pit road.
Oh, it is, Eli. It's kept them working hard all week long. We did an update a while ago that Butch Miller has brought his truck in behind the wall. He's had a terrible week, crashed the primary truck. Somebody spun in front of him. He had to take to the dirt, hit the wall, and now they've got a transmission problem. Larry, I got a question about what you're talking about. Another thing, in addition to suspension, is what the engine goes through at a place like this, running so slow and then so fast. It really goes through its complete range of emotions, if you will, and you can have some valve train problems if you're not careful.
Well, it really is hard on valves, and again, the downshifting and upshifting, you know, these trucks have rev limiters in them, which actually cuts the cylinders out if you over-rev them, but still, if you over-rev them too fast, it'll turn the RPMs up, and it's pretty much a motorman's nightmare. There you see Mike Skinner. He's moved around Borsett into second place.
Boris is now running in third. Mike Bliss is fourth. Rick Crawford is running in fifth as we ride with Bliss. 25 of 81 laps complete. Back with you, the Lund Look 275 is now under caution. Why? Because there's one truck right there pointed the wrong way. That's Brian Reffner.
Brian got a little out of shape over there in turn 10 and never did get it refired, and so he may have something transmission-wise or engine-wise that's caused him to be in that position. He's still sitting in the truck and waiting to get him out of the way there.
He ran fourth here in 1995 in an American Speed Association race, but today it's not going to be quite as strong a day. Tough break for Brian Reffner. Meanwhile, Boris said over the last lap or so has dropped a couple, three positions. Glenn, are they concerned? Are they saying anything on pit road?
Oh, absolutely, Eli. There's a little problem. Jay Smith, the crew chief, is talking to him right now. And Jay, Boris seems to have dropped off. What's the problem?
Don't really know what it is. The motor's been skipping pretty much all the way around the racetrack. He says he's killing him guys in the corner, but it won't run down the straightaways. And we're not real sure what it is. We're going to try some stuff on the carburetor, change a battery, a few other little things, but we really don't know what it is.
This caution helps, but you're still sure you can go all the way this half?
We're not pitting.
That doesn't mean he's sure, it just means he's not pitting.
So that's the strategy as it unfolds. Tough break for Boris. Remember, you got to have the strength on the straightaway here because the front stretch, the drag strip, and the runoff area, 2,484 feet. The back stretch, 1,442 feet. So you've got to have it dialed in all the way around. And certainly, number 16 truck does. That is Ron Hornaday. A streak of races began with the win at Bristol Motor Speedway. He led every single lap. 2 weeks later, he went to victory lane at the famed Milwaukee Mile. The next week, Louisville, Hornaday dipped under Mike Bliss, took the checkered flag, and he had won three of his last four. Then last week, his wife was looking on in Colorado. Lindy saw Ron take his third straight victory and a Craftsman Truck Series record 4 wins out of 5 races.
Nothing like momentum.
Today, you got that right.
Nothing like momentum. And, you know, they really got it going right now, and he's sitting there right up at the front again today. So, and Ron's always been tough on these road courses, so I'd say he stands as good a chance as any of getting those 4 wins in a row.
If I may, for a moment, shifting gears, if you will, the Brickyard 400 coming up next weekend. And of course, everybody knows, Larry, you are the crew chief for Dale Earnhardt. You guys were there testing. How'd things go? What's the thought process for next weekend?
Well, with both of our cars, Earnhardt and Skinner, the 3 and the 31, we spent 5 days total there testing. Had Dave Marcus helping us out, Bobby Hillen doing some engine stuff for us. Had a good test, and you know, we feel like with the 3 Brickyards that's been run, Dale Earnhardt, Richard Childress, and Larry McReynolds, we carry a lot of success into there. We like to win the first Brickyard with Ernie before right. The cut tire. Dale did win the second Brickyard. And then last year with the Robert Yates cars, Dale Jarrett and Ernie Irvin, we had the 1-2 punch. So maybe we can carry our momentum into the Brickyard.
Well, Dave Marcus is something when he tests a car, isn't he?
He's got a great feel for a race car, and it really gives you good feedback, and he's really been a lot of help to the Goodwrench team.
Here we go now for the restart. The restart spot is where they show that scoreboard where they give you the results of the drag racing events. We'll ride with Mike Bliss here. As soon as they get to that scoreboard area, they are free to go.
Hornaday gets restart, but looked like Skinner kept pace with him just a little bit, as well as Mike Bliss, as they downshift headed into turn one here.
Today, Skinner, and the man with whom we are riding, Mike Bliss.
28 laps into this race, you heard Mike Bliss as he got back to the throttle. He wasn't able to just completely nail it. He kind of had to feather into it. You have to drive these road courses with the throttle as well as the steering wheel.
There's Boris Said. He's got major problems now off the pace. Everybody is going by Boris Said. It is an extremely hot day today. Temperature again over 100. High humidity. Glenn, any problems on the pit lane as far as guys checking in as to how they're going to feel?
Oh, yeah, Eli. Brian Cunningham driving the number 57 truck has had Doug George standing by to relieve him. Doug has gotten in the truck. Brian collapsed from the heat. He has been sick. He's had some kind of virus, and it finally caught up with him. Meanwhile, I'm in the back of Rich Bickle's pits right here. These guys are working hard to get cold towels, ice packs, and ice water ready for Rich at halftime. They're talking more about what they're going to do to keep him cool than they are what they're going to do to change on the truck. Meanwhile, we're going to go down now, check on Boris Said. I'll get right back to you.
So that's the update there. There is the Cunningham truck now with Doug George at the wheel. So again, we don't want to overstate the fact, because the NASCAR Winston Cup team running 100 degree temperature at Daytona when you're there for the Pepsi 400. But this weekend, there's absolutely been no break whatsoever. Temperatures over 100, high humidity, barely a cloud in the sky. As you see overhead, it's totally pristine and blue. There's very little area to hide.
Saw Mike Skinner locking that right front up there as he went off in the corner, locking those brakes up. Eli, there's several things. There you see Boris Said. He's in the pits, and they're jacking the rear end up. He may have tore a gear up of something. It looked like he just all of a sudden was off the pace.
And that's normally what you look for when you jack up the rear of a race vehicle, something in the rear end, obviously.
They're trying to see you run a ratchet rear end here, and what they're trying to do now, they're trying to see if both wheels is pulling.
Glenn, what can you tell from down there?
Exactly what Larry's talking about. They got a rear gearing problem, and you're right, Larry. They got it jacked up trying to spin both tires. When Boris came in, he didn't cut it off. It cut off on its own because of something in the gearing. He couldn't stop it, couldn't control it. Now they're wanting to work on the axle cap. He may have a broken axle. I don't know. But they're definitely got a rear gearing problem. We're going to have to put him behind the wall. Check it out. Tough break.
You know, we talked about how hard this racetrack is on the engines and transmissions. It's hard on all of the drivetrain, the dry shaft, and can be very hard on axles. You know, the RPMs are so low, and then all of a sudden you're back to the gas, really turning the RPMs up. That can twist one of those axles right in two.
So Boris Said going behind the wall. A big spin here. Tom Hubert coming back out onto the drag strip area. There he is in the Dana Dodge up against the tire barrier. Now, there can be caution in that one corner only. You don't have to have a full course yellow. They'll wait and see whether Hubert can get that Dana Dodge for Kurt Rohrig going again. We'll see exactly what happened. Watch.
He come off in the last corner and looked like it just come around with him, but an awful lot of smoke. So he may have had a transmission or an engine problem.
And we've got a full course yellow. It doesn't look as though Bobby Hamilton helped him from the rear. It was tough to tell. Just tough. Bobby's there in that number one truck. But we are going to a full course yellow here at lap number 30 for the Dana Dodge. The leader is Ron Hornaday.
Sign up for SprintSense Dime a Minute Rate now.
Sports, these same NASCAR Craftsman trucks will be fighting it out on the high banks of Nashville Speedway. It all starts August 16th at 7 p.m. Eastern. And then following that race at 10 p.m. Eastern, it is the most prestigious race in sprint car racing, the Pennzoil World of Outlaws battling it out in the Amoco Knoxville Nationals Saturday, August 16th, right here on the leader. Motorsports coverage, TNN Motorsports. Under caution, brought out when Tom Hubert spun the Dana Dodge off turn 12. We ride with Jimmy Hensley, and let's check in with Glenn Jarrett.
Hey guys, they have pulled Boris Said's truck behind the wall here. Just as we speculated, axle problem. This is the one that came out. It's not supposed to look like that. It's supposed to be much longer. Now they got a problem getting that other piece out of the center section. Meanwhile, Boris sitting here getting several drinks of cold water. Man, that thing just let go on you all at once. That's too bad. You had a great truck.
Yeah, it's unfortunate. I mean, all the guys at Federated Auto Parts and 1-800 Collect gave me a really good truck today, and I just appreciate their support. Ernie back at home told me to be patient, and I was, but we had a really good truck. fortunately, we had a little bit of mist, so we were just kind of conserving the gas till halftime. You know, we definitely had the fastest truck out there. You know, unfortunately, we broke an axle under the yellow, and, you know, that's just an unfortunate part of racing. It's pretty hot out here, but the track's a lot of fun. I'm just drinking plenty of Cytomax. Stuff keeps you cool.
Well, you know, he looks pretty cool for a guy that's been out there in the heat of battle. Doesn't look near as hot and worn out as I thought he would be, but they're going to get the thing fixed and get him back out there.
There you see Tom Hubert's truck being pushed back towards the garage and pit area. Again, if you're just tuning in, here's why we are under caution for the third time today.
Here they come down underneath the bridge. You see some smoke coming out of Tom Hubert's truck right there. And again, I almost get the feeling that something let go on that truck. A lot of smoke out of it. So I don't think it was just that it got away from him.
Still couldn't tell whether he and Bobby Hamilton made contact or not. We'll just have to wait and find out as we talk to the fellows who were involved there. Got to tip the hat to Tony Raines in the number 19 truck, that Pennzoil machine, running right there in fifth spot. And Larry, that's one of the guys you talked about in the pre-race segment today, who is a former winner here and could do well, and indeed he is.
Well, he's being patient, and that's what you got to do at a road course. And just, we always have had a theory about road racing. If you stay on the racetrack and nothing breaks and you make decent calls in the pits, you can finish in the top five normally at a road race. And they're just biding their time, quietly have worked their way into fifth position. Know they got a lot of laps to go here and just need to be there at the end.
We had also mentioned earlier in our telecast about Kenny Irwin. It was during our starting lineup area. We said it's his first road race in 8 years, and there is the Ray Bestis truck for Kenny Irwin. Started 32nd, currently being shown in 15th spot. So he's had himself a very solid run going for the Cintas Rookie of the Year honors here on the NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series.
Actually had to use a provisional spot, an owner's provisional to get in. A little bit of damage on the right rear there. Don't know that it'll cause any harm to the performance, and don't look like it's near the tire rubbing or anything. So, again, he just needs to be patient, keep working his way to the front, and see what happens here near the end.
Next week, this series is going to Indianapolis Raceway Park. The trucks will be running there on Thursday evening. And have you seen whose names are on the entry list for next week?
Quite a number of drivers are going to show up there. That's pretty normal for Indianapolis.
Eliseo Salazar has tendered an entry. The great ASA standout, Gary St. Amant, has tendered an entry. It's going to be very, very interesting to see how some of these fellows will be getting into a truck for a very first time, particularly after the high-powered, lower-weight IRL or IndyCars, see how they do next weekend.
I'm sure the biggest, toughest job will be when they first get there is trying to make the show. That's going to be the toughest part.
Hornaday the leader as we get set to go back to green. Mike Skinner is second. Mike Bliss is third. Rick Crawford will restart in fourth. Tony Raines fifth. Kevin Harvick a good run. He's in sixth. Joe Ruttman back up to seventh. He was the very first truck to pit for the early fuel stop back on lap six. Joe Ruttman is now in seventh. Jay Sauter is eighth. Dave Resendiz is ninth. Rick Corelli will restart 10th. Rich Bickle 11th. Dorsey Schrader running well in 12th. Randy Tolsma in 13th. Jack Sprague is 14th. Kenny Irwin is 15th. 16th is Bobby Hamilton. Bob Keselowski is 17th. Jimmy Hensley will go 18th. And that is the full list of the trucks currently on the lead lap.
Sure, during this caution period, Eli, the drivers have really talked to their crew chiefs about what their trucks are doing. They've run 32 laps, coming to lap 33, about 9 laps to the halfway. They got to start thinking about what kind of adjustments they can make to be on top of it for that last run.
The Lund look 275 back under green. Look at Joe Ruttman gets around Harvick on the quick jump. That's that yellow LCI truck. Moves in and around Crawford as well. Nice jump there for Joe. Riding now with Mike Bliss. Bliss is in third. Well, that was too good of a restart for Joe Ruttman. They're going to have to black flag him for jumping the restart, and around goes Harvick. That's in the new section of the course. And around he went. Spears Manufacturing making a driver change a couple of weeks ago. Dan Press got out of the truck, and Harvick took over, effective with the race last week in Colorado. Well, this is going to be a crusher for Ruttman, but again, everything will tighten up at halfway, so it's not a devastating break for Joe Ruttman, but he'll go from fourth all the way to the back of the field. Here's Harvick's spin again.
Just might have got a little bit of help there from the back as they was going in that turn. I think that's Rick Corelli there behind him. He may have got a little bit of help. Don't look like the truck ever stalled out on him. Just, again, couldn't get back in position on the racetrack for all the trucks coming.
And the leader is Ron Hornaday. Took the top spot at lap 24. We're at lap 33, nearing halfway. Stop and go penalty, and the stop is complete. You see Dave Resendiz right behind, having made a pit stop as well. And just clarifying that, very much like Winston Cup racing, as you there see Resendiz, you definitely can't pass. You can pass in one direction, Larry. You can't pass in another, however, on a restart.
Well, once the green flag is displayed, even if you have not crossed the start-finish line, you can pass to the right-hand side. Now, obviously, when you cross the start-finish line, you pass, you're back to racing.
Sure.
But you can't pass anyone to that green flag comes out, and you can't pass anyone to the left. And Joe was, he was all the way down against the left side of the drag strip, and NASCAR caught it and brought him in for a stop and go. He won't go a lap down, but the thing about it was, six laps to the halfway, he's got a lot of ground to make up.
There you see the battle up front. Hornaday, the leader. Then Skinner, the 93. You're riding with third place Mike Bliss. You can also see the tires starting to give up just a wee bit at this late stage of the first half.
They've run 36 laps, and about 31 of them have been green flag laps. And again, all of the truck races are tire management. You don't have the luxury like us in Winston Cup. Every time the yellow flag flies, you come in and get four more Goodyears. These guys have to know how to manage their tires, and you can't abuse these tires. If you ever abuse them, they're history. You get to put four more on.
At this point, they are showing a grand total of 14 trucks on the lead lap as we near halfway at beautiful Heartland Park, Topeka, Kansas. Vent visor, the most practical accessory for your truck. And that's how the numbers look going into today's Lund Look 275. There's the top 10, including Kenny Irwin, who also leads the Cintas Rookie of the Year battle. On the racetrack now, good battle for third. There is second place Skinner. Bliss is third, and Rick Crawford in fourth. Bliss had made a bid there, but couldn't quite make the move on Skinner.
And Rick Crawford, he had been all over the, guess what would you call it, the rear tailgate.
Exactly.
Of Mike Bliss's truck, and lost a little ground when he didn't quite clear him getting into turn one.
Boris said after the problems to the rear of the truck, he has now returned. So if you're following his fortunes, Boris back on the racetrack. There he comes now, but he finds himself four laps down. Not quite as disastrous as it could have been.
Well, most of their repair work was done during the caution,
right.
So that enabled
there goes
them.
Second Skinner. Place Skinner. And caution is on the speedway. A full course yellow. A full course yellow being put out at turn 10. Skinner able to continue, but he brings out the full course yellow. He was running in second spot. He gets back in line in 12th, just ahead of Jimmy Hensley, who is running 13th.
He was fortunate, the kind of ride he took, that he didn't lose any more positions than he did.
So our fourth caution of the afternoon comes out as Mike Skinner, returning to the NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series. The reason they were so quick with that caution, too, is that there is a report from an observer that there is a streak of oil in turn 10 over which Skinner went, and that sent the truck looping. So they are deciding to put out the caution and take a look right through that area, turn 10. Of course, the black area, that's the groove, and there is some sealer that you see there, but at the same time, observers who are right on top of the speedway say there is a streak of oil, and better to be safe than sorry.
NASCAR has spotters all around the racetrack, particularly in the corners, and that's their job, is to watch the racetrack to see if any debris or oil or water or anything's put down.
Watch what happens here as we ride with Mike Bliss, and Skinner's right ahead of him.
Sorry, the tail end of the truck started really moving around there, like he did get in some liquid or something,
yeah.
Like it just got away from him. It didn't just come around like it got loose with him. It's like maybe his rear tires was in some oil or liquid.
Down on the pit lane right now, Rob Morgan has the hood up. And it looks as though they're also working in the driver's compartment. Oh, there's Morgan right there. There's Morgan being helped out of the truck, lying down or being bathed in ice water. And we'll have Glenn update us quickly as to who it was that climbed in. Again, folks, not to overstate it, temperatures here, even with the breeze that you can see blowing and rustling everybody's hair, temperatures over 100 degrees. The humidity makes it feel a good bit warmer than that, and it's been that way all weekend long. There's the breeze and the umbrellas, too, that help shade some folks here in the heartland of America. 275 is under caution, and even though we are shy of halfway by a lap, there is a report of a streak of oil pretty much all the way around this 2.1 mile road course. Someone has been putting oil down, so NASCAR has decided to bring the trucks in and do the halfway break right here. And they're within a lap anyway of where they were scheduled for it, and that'll give the track cleanup crew an uninhibited shot at cleaning the entire racing surface without having to dodge the race trucks while they're out there. So we're going to take the break here a lap early so as to facilitate track cleaning. As soon as we come back, Glenn will be patrolling the pit lane, and he'll give you the halftime report. We're right back. Mark, Topeka, Kansas, the Lund Look 275 is at halfway. Ron Hornaday is the race leader in 95. He won the race here and at Sears Point. In 96, he won at Watkins Glen. I guess Glenn Jarrett, we shouldn't be surprised he's leading now.
Not on the road course, Eli. And he came out, took an ice water bath, got a new ice pack around his midsection there. Ron, kind of hot out there, isn't it?
I'll tell you what, not too bad, but this Napa Brakes Chevrolet is running awesome. And I'll tell you what, there's a lot of rocks out there, so you got to have one truck Chevrolet to do it. But cool packs, borrowed a helmet from Rick Corelli, a little cool helmet. I've never been fresher.
Fred Graves told me they were going to put a little tape on the nose and we're going to put maybe a half round of bite in the left rear. Said that it just won't turn like you want it to.
Yeah, just left-hand turns. You know, the tires really get a lot of rubber on them. You get down the first corner, it just pushes off real bad. So we're going to put a little bit in there to try to get it to cut on the left-handers and tighten it up for the right. Other than that, Napa Chevrolet's awesome.
Four in a row looking good right now.
We're not looking at that right now. We're just looking at the big picture for that championship.
Okay, back to you, Eli.
That's Ron Hornaday trying to keep himself zeroed in on the job at hand.
Well, they're going to put a little tape on the front end, and that'll help the truck cut a little better because it puts downforce in it. And I think I understood them say they're going to put around in the left rear. That will actually tighten it up for the left-handers where the tape will make it actually turn both directions.
Ron Hornaday, 15 career wins of the NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series. Running in second, Mike Bliss, a good run for the ASE truck. There he is.
We're just talking about, Mike, a great run so far. What are they doing to the truck? How do you like it so far?
So far, the ASE Ford's strong. It's real good through the slow left and rights. A little tight to the left on the fast. We're just going to take a little wedge out and go from there. I mean, I'm not a big road racer. We just got a truck and finish in the top three, and that's what I want to do today.
Well, Hornaday is a pretty good road racer, known for that. Have you got anything for him, or you just going to ride it out, see what happens?
I'm going to ride it out, see what happens, and see, you know, I don't want to do nothing stupid, not finish.
Well, you can see his conservative approach has got him all the way up to the front of the pack so far, guys. Don't count Mike Bliss out of this thing.
Never do with